Good morning, everybody. Welcome back to General English class for 2nd BCom, 3rd semester, affiliated to Bangalore University, session 31. Let's continue with the lesson, Professional Guides to Cultivating Humanity, written by Hema Raghavan. Let's have a quick recap of session 30. Hema Raghavan came across a thoughtful advertisement which said, urgently needed, need just 6 professionals to make our world a beautiful place. These professionals are need not to be searched outside. Everyone has it within, but not aware of the potential within. It is like a spark which is within us, lamp in a bushel, but we all remain in darkness. Like Matthew Arnold's Call a Gypsy, who waits for a spark to fall from heaven. We have a potential, but we are not aware of it. According to Hema Raghavan, the first professional whom we need is an electrician. Why do we need an electrician? To light up the relationship that has been lost in modern world of technology. Yes, today there is no relationship. The interpersonal relationship is lost due to modern technology and social media. Be it Facebook, Twitter, Instagram or WhatsApp. There is a loss of human contact, and not only that, we have lost the feeling and recognition. There is a loss of interpersonal rapport. So, we need an electrician to make a current to pass. The current should be made of words, emotions, feelings, gestures, and physical togetherness, which is the need of the hour. Yes. Why do we need all these things? In order to survive, in order to have a free flow of current, so that it would help us to restore the vitality of interpersonal communication. Yes, all of us have the electrician within us, so we have to rekindle that electrician in a way of words, emotions, feelings, gestures, and physical togetherness. Let us see the second professional who's the need of the hour, an optician. Who is an optician? An optician is a person who helps us to see the world with a better eyesight. Yes, optician is a person who sells spectacles. But why do we need an optician? Cultural heritage accounts for tangible and intangible characteristics. Yes. Unity in diversity. What do you mean by unity in diversity? We have to live with different kinds of people from different cultural heritage. We have to understand their characteristics. Now it is overloaded with cultural influence from across the globe. Earlier we had unity in diversity, but today we have an influence, cultural influence from across the globe. Yes, due to social media again, due to modern technology, we get to know different types of culture. Cultural rigidities will obstruct or reverse the process of globalization process. In this world of globalization, cultural rigidity, what do you mean by cultural rigidity? Holding on to one's culture, thinking that our culture is superior to other cultures, which will obstruct the process of globalization. Yes, it might reverse the process. As a result, if one sticks on to their cultural heritage, what happens? He gets alienated from the global community. he might not be able to mingle with other people. So, what is the need of the hour? We need a balanced inherited cultural legacy with a new accelerating culture. We have to balance these two. In order to be with that, in order to not to be left out, what do we have to do? We have to maintain a balance between our own culture and try to accept the other cultural heritage. As a result, we will be able to understand the other cultural legacy. So we need an optician to give us a specs or give us a new eyesight by looking at this beautiful cultural legacy. This can be simply explained with an example by looking through a window. When we look outside through a window, if we concentrate on the dirt of the window, we will only look at the dirt. But if we stop looking at that and look through the window to the outside world, we might end up looking at the beautiful scenery which is waiting for us to admire. Yes, if we are mingling with people, if we are working with people from different cultural heritage, we might have to call for adjustments. We might have to adjust with lots of things. Yes, we should have a balance. We should try to accept the differences in the cultural heritage and not be rigid not to accept the other cultures. Yes, this is where the optician is needed to change the outlook of life. Where is the optician again? It is within us. Let us try to include others, include other people from other cultural heritage. Let's have a broad outlook so that we can be with them in the world of globalization. Let's draw a balance between our culture and culture of other people around the globe. Belief in magnificent past lead to discovery of time warp and tradition inadequate to face the complexities of globalized world. Yes, if we keep on looking at the past glory, thinking about the past glory, we might lose the precious time of present world, which is becoming globalized. We should have the pride of the past, but we should also have the outlook to change, or the mindset to change our outlook in order to accept the differences, embrace the differences. To take refuge in the past is to live with optics of monument. Yes, if we keep on looking at the past, or if we keep on thinking about the past glory, it is like living with optics of monuments. It is of no use. We look at the glory, yes, but we also have to look at the, or appreciate, try and appreciate the legacy of other cultures. There are four disadvantages if we take the refuge in the past. We see from the distance, outside has a halo, passivity that stops to change from within. Yes, if we keep on looking or keep on thinking about the past glory, it might stop us from the change that should happen within us. So, let's try to create a global optics in order to balance the tradition with modernity. We shouldn't lose out our tradition. Yes, we have to hold on to our tradition, but also pave some way to accept the modernity. Thus, we need an optician to have a broader outlook of the world to accept, adjust, and to appreciate. Go through these YouTube videos for further details. Thank you.